All right, let's look at direct 1-2 addition and alpha beta unsaturated ketones, aldehydes, and a little bit about carboxylic acid derivatives. So our most explanatory additions are going to be, or predictable, will be direct addition to ketones and aldehydes. And so if we look at this example ketone, we see the difference here between a 1-2 direct addition and a 1-4 conjugate addition. So we would call position one, the carbonyl oxygen, to define the diene system. So 1, 2, 3, 4, that's the alpha beta conjugated ketones. So there's a couple ways to label it there. 1, 2, 3, 4, the alpha and beta positions. And so we would call direct addition a nucleophile attacking with its lone pair there that carbonyl directly, all right, as opposed to attacking the 4 position, which is conjugate. So what we're going to focus on in this lesson are nucleophiles and substrates that focus on the 1-2 addition as the major product. You might get a little bit of both, but you're going to typically lean towards 1-2 addition with these strong bases, hard nucleophiles as we're going to call them, that attack 1-2. And so just finishing out this mechanism, we just attacked with our nucleophile kicking up. These are typically anionic for our direct addition nucleophiles. So when they attack, they kick up oxygen to a minus, they take a zero formal charge. And so there we look, we have no leaving group on our substrate here. And so we go to a second step, which is acidification. We are required to acidify in order to cap off this proton. So we then take the proton there from hydronium, just lower the pH enough to get to our protonated alcohol, the direct 1-2 addition product. All right, so the anions that we're going to use for nucleophiles here will follow this mechanistic path. Looking at a more concrete definition here, our nucleophiles that are going to be good direct addition nucleophiles will also be strong bases. So as we described for substitution elimination, the same nucleophiles apply in this situation. So a strong base, we defined that base, the anionic form is the base, the conjugate acid of its of the base form is going to have a pKa greater than 15 for these strong bases. So whatever our nucleophile is, put a proton on, look up the pKa in a table. If it's greater than 15, it's going to be a good nucleophile and a strong base. Also called a hard base or a hard nucleophile, meaning it prefers more polar positions. The carbonyl is the most polar position on these alpha beta systems. And so what things qualify? Well, enolates can qualify. The enolates of a tertiary amide, for example, would be a good nucleophile, alpha carbon nucleophile for these. The enolate of an ester, for example, the enolate, sort of enolate of a nitrile looks like this, right? So it's a little bit different. It looks a little different than a normal enolate, but it's still going to be a harder nucleophile. Ketones, we're going to look at in a moment, aldehydes. Acetylides are good hard nucleophiles. Their pKas are in the 20s. Okay, we can get some mixture with those, but typically they do go 1-2 as far as major products are concerned. The amide ion is a strong base, a good nucleophile. So primary amines with a proton taken off of that negative formal charge, very strong base, hard nucleophile. Granular reagents, we'll look at lithium aluminum hydrides and organolithium reagents. In particular, among the organometallics, the organolithiums are best when we want to zero in on that 1-2 addition product. Lithium aluminum hydride, much, much better than sodium hydride as far as picking that 1-2 reduction. So let's have a look at some products we'd get from some of these. And so again, we're focusing on the 1-2 position of this 4-carbon system here, this diene system, or double, I guess not two alkenes, but a alpha beta unsaturated ketone has two pi bonds like a diene system. We label dienes in this manner as well. So let's just focus on that two position, cap off our proton. We put our alkyl group on with the Grignard reagent. Lithium aluminum hydride, same thing, is going to create that O minus at first. It's going to add a hydrogen, but with a hydrogen, we're not drawing that in the skeletal structure, and so we end up with here just our alcohol, okay, once we protonate. With an enolate, suppose we made a kinetic enolate from an unsymmetrical ketone at negative 78 degrees, so we'd get the enolate on two alpha carbons here, but we'd prefer the less substituted side in kinetic conditions. 0 degrees, we'd prefer the enolate to the more substituted side. But here we've created a hard nucleophile. And yeah, these do add 1,2, and they add 1,4, but they also add 1,2 when they're free like this. We get a mixture, really, of 1,2 and 1,4. And it's hard to control. It's a big problem in synthesis that a lot of chemists have devoted their careers to solving the selectivity of how to go 1,2, how to go 1,4 with enolate additions. And so this is one I'll show you, but just note that the 1,2 addition, it's not going to be as great a yield as it would be for, say, a lithium aluminum hydride reduction like we saw above. But in general, what we'll see is that enolate collapse. The alpha carbon pi bond reaches out to either the 4 position, or as we're going to show in this lesson here, the 1,2 addition product, a hard nucleophile. Steric hindrance plays a role here. Even with Grignard reagents, if we have a bulky substituent on the Grignard, if we have a bulky substituent here, it can bias to the 1,4 product as well. In general, though, they tend to go toward the 1,2. Organolithiums have a higher selectivity to the 1,2 as well. Looking at this, though, when we add our enolate, we've got to keep track of carbons here. So I'm going to redraw the alpha-beta system exactly as we drew it a moment ago. And then I'm going to attach this alpha carbon here to that position that we attacked. Okay. And so how many carbons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 from the alpha. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. From the alpha carbon, where is our carbonyl at? It's at the second position, okay? And so we've got to make sure that we're keeping track of everything when all these carbon groups are moving around and attacking. So we can draw it upside down, left, right, either way. Ultimately, though, when you lower the pH, you will cap off this proton, and we've got our 1,2 addition product. Another note here, in addition to hard nucleophiles, if the alpha beta system is more reactive than a ketone or an aldehyde, in other words, it's an anhydride or an acyl halide carboxylic acid derivative, the addition product to the direct 1,2 position is going to be preferred in all cases because you've got a good leaving group. So even with a weak nucleophile here, we just drew this the nucleophile's weak, the base is weak. We just used this in order to illustrate the point here that we've got a system that will prefer to form a tetrahedral intermediate like we're used to seeing for acid halides. And then a solvent molecule or base from solution can remove this proton, forming our leaving group here. We had two good leaving groups before, now we only have one. And so then we can kick off that chlorine, the good leaving group. What do we get? We get a carboxylic acid from that direct addition. Okay, so anhydrides work in the same fashion. We're going to favor that 1,2 addition every time, even with a soft, weaker nucleophile.